And g'day guys, I'm wiring up a Haltech ECU onto a 1UZ. Now, the wiring principle to me is the same for all of the ECUs. In fact, whether they're standard or aftermarket, all the same sort of principles apply. I'm going to go over this one in a step-by-step, quite quickly, on some of the basics of getting your engine running with the Haltech. I did a setup video just recently, so hopefully that's out. And I'm using a 2500 because I'm also doing auto control. Whether you're doing your base model, like your 550, or maybe, so that would be grouped injection, and you could do wasted spark with that one, or whether you're using like a 950, or like me doing the 2500, the same sort of stuff applies. We're connecting wires and connecting it to the ECU. So onto the engine, into the ECU, set it up correctly, and it will work and run. Let's get into it. We're going to do cam and crank sensors first. So what have I got here? Let's see. I've got my own diagram that I made with, I drew my own little picture of the plug, and then I listed what I'm putting in. I've got the Haltech information. So I just deciphered this into a form that worked for me. Of course, we've got the ECU. So that's getting ready to be fitted to the car. I've got a new crank sensor plug. I've got a box of terminals. I've got some seals too. I've got a cam sensor plug. I'm using the left hand cam. So it shows on the diagram, the wiring for the cam and crank. It's got digital or a Hall effect or a reluctor. So we're using a reluctor sensor because that's what the UZ runs. And it shows that we to connect the crank positive into number one, the cam positive into number two. So that would be these one and two. This plug is also numbered on the back of it itself, so you can tell where you're going to put your wires. It's really helpful. It shows that the cam negative and crank negative, over here, the wiring diagram, you can see that we don't use the signal ground. We use the crank positive into number one, of course, and then the negative is into pin five. What it also shows, the 12 volt, if you're using a pre-made loom, then you may have a 12 volt, you're not going to connect that, and you're not going to connect the signal ground. It does also show here in the picture, so you've got this little line here, that's for the shields coming down to a pin 15, a signal ground. So that's really quite straightforward. Crank positive, crank negative, crank cam positive, and cam negative. In my wiring, that's knock sensors. These two are my cam and crank sensors. There's the shielding. So what I'm going to do there is I'm going to crimp on a short length of black wire to go to the signal ground later on. And I'm going to connect up my plugs and crimp this, ready to put plugs on the cam sensor and the crank sensor wiring. I'm going to leave this on the engine because I think it'll be easier for everyone to sort of comprehend what I'm doing if I'm doing it on old yellow. You can see I've already prepared the loom. I've sized it. All the wiring is sitting in the right positions for where I want it to go. I am doing coil on plug. I'll talk about that when I'm in that section. Let's focus at the moment on the cam and crank sensors. Righto, I've done the wiring I needed to do, and I've added a black wire to the shield on the way I've done it. If you're running a breakout loom, then that's already done in the loom. And all you need to do now is put the wires into the plugs. Crank sensor loom, crank sensor plug. Number one is the outside wire. Or these plugs actually have got the numbers on them, but on if we're looking at the back, the right hand side is number one, the left hand side is number two. That's so when you look at this side, it's 1, 2, you're like a book, but I always work from the back, so it's backwards. So we pop the wires in. I'm going to pop the crank sensor positive in first. I'm going to go over here. And I know that this one is the crank sensor positive. However, what I'm going to do is pop the multimeter over it. Now, the reason I know it's the positive is the somehow I managed to put 20 gauge wire for this one and 22 for the other, and it's pretty obvious when you're working with the so size wires all the time, you can tell the size really quickly. When we look at the B plug information, crank sensor positive is number one, and in it goes. And make sure it clicks all the way home, and that makes the negative pin 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it goes. And then we do the same. Oh, I better put the negative into the plug, put the lock in, and then we do the same with the cam sensor. Same deal, right hand at the back is number one, which is the positive. Clip the lock in, grab that one. On the information, it says number two for cam positive. Bam. And it goes. Real simple, real easy. And these two blacks will eventually go out to the sensor ground, as shown in the picture, which is on pin 15. But I'm going to do that later on. So that's the first part of the wiring done. Cam and crank sensors, those are your speed and your home or your sink, depending on what you want to call it. I'm going to move on in the next video and do some analog volts, the water temp, the air temp, the TPS, those sorts of ones. So I hope this has been helpful. We'll talk to you again soon. Catch you later.